Hello, bookworms! Welcome to my March book haul. These are my favorite videos to film because I love book shopping and I love showing you guys what I got while I was book shopping. And this is going to be, I don't know, moderately sized, but I am going to attempt not to really spend too much money in April. So my April book haul will be a little bit smaller than this one, hopefully not counting books that I already pre-ordered because I don't think that's fair. You know, so those will be there. But anyway, March book haul. The first book that I got this month is Dead to Me. And this book is by Mary McCoy. It looks really, really good. It takes place in like old Hollywood in the 1940s. And there's like a murder mystery that goes on. It says here, the people who live in the nicest houses have the dirtiest secrets. And I see this very glamorous woman that looks like she's laying on a bed and she's got pearls draped on her, and then there's like blood splatter on the cover. So that's just like something that I would be really into. I like historical novels. I like mysteries, and I love, love, love the 40s. So I'm really looking forward to reading this one like ASAP. The next book that I picked up this month is Grave Mercy. This is by Robin Lefevers. So it's the first book in the His Fair Assassins trilogy, and it's about this girl who becomes a handmaiden to death. And she gets trained to be an assassin, and I heard that's very like fantastical, so I love fantasy, and I've heard like nothing but good things about this trilogy. The entire thing is already published, which is one of the reasons why I was so excited to get it. I am not gonna have to wait at all before I find out what happens. The next book will be very easily accessible. So this one, I'm looking forward to reading it. The next book that I have is Famous in Love. This is by Rebecca Searle. I can't say names for some reason this time. So this book, I actually won in a contest for the book blogger Love-a-thon that was hosted by Alexa Loves Books. And we did a challenge with like taking photos of books, and I won that challenge. So this is one of the books that she sent me. I'm really looking forward to reading this. It's a contemporary novel. It's about a girl who gets like plucked out of obscurity and kind of like becomes a movie star overnight. And they actually just announced that ABC Family is going to be developing a television series based on this book, and it's going to be starring Bella Thorne, who was just in the Duff movie. She was the mean girl in that. Didn't like her. She was really nasty. I am looking forward to seeing her in this. And it's also being developed by the same people that did Pretty Little Liars, and I love that show, so I think that I need to read this, like, very soon, or at least before the television show comes out. The next book that I have is Cruel Beauty. This is by Rosamond Hodge, and this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. After reading A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas, I don't expect any other Beauty and the Beast retelling to like even come close to how I felt about that book, but I do really like that fairy tale, so I am always looking to read more retellings about it. The next book that I picked up is The Chaos of Stars by Kirsten White. And this book is about a girl who is the human daughter of Greek gods, hence The Chaos of the Stars. This sounds really interesting. I love Greek mythology, so I'm looking forward to seeing how this is done. I think it's set in like a modern world, so it will be different than the mythology that I've read in the past, but as we know, Greek gods are always like kind of vindictive, and they are always just causing chaos. So I think that's why they're so interesting to read about. Next, I have The Darkest Part of the Forest by Holly Black. I've never actually read a book by Holly Black yet, so I am looking forward to checking this one out. One thing that I really like about it is that this is a standalone novel, so if I don't love it, I'm not committed to reading three or four more books of it. It's just this one story and it's completed. So that to me is like really, really exciting. I think that we need more standalone fantasy books. It's about fairies. So it takes place in a world where there are humans who know that fairies exist. So that's like kind of a different take of any kind of like fairy story that I've read before. So yes. The Darkest Part of the Forest. The next book that I have is Serafina. This is by Rachel Hartman, and it is about dragons. It is a fantasy novel. Again, obviously dragons. The second book just came out, Shadowscale, and lots of my favorite bloggers have talked about this book and talked about how wonderful this book is, and a lot of people I know have actually already reread it, so I think that's like a sign that this is probably very wonderful, and I look forward to reading it. So lastly, I have some graphic novels that I picked up. First is The Fade Out. This is by Ed Brubaker and Sean Phillips, and this is a noir mystery type book. I think it also takes place in the 40s. I just love the way that Brubaker writes, and like mystery and noir is just so perfect for him. So I like his superhero stuff a lot too. Like this Daredevil run, amazing. So I'm really looking forward to reading this because I like when he does this kind of stuff. Next, I have the second volume of Sex Criminals. This is by Matt Frection and Chip Zdarsky. I really love this series. The first book is like just so funny. The writers themselves are kind of hipstery, so everything about these books is just like weird, but really cool and really random and interesting. So I'm excited to read the next part of it. I think I also heard that they're developing this to be a television series as well. For those who don't know, it's about these two people who are able to freeze time after they've had sex, and they decide to take that time and go and rob banks. So that's a different premise if I've ever heard one. Lastly, I have volumes 1 and 2 of Coffin Hill, and this is by Caitlin Kitteridge, and the art is Inaki Miranda. I've actually already read the first volume of this. I read it in single issues as it was coming out, and I really loved it and love the art style. This is also like a mystery. It takes place in the woods in this town where like weird things are happening. So I'm looking forward to reading the second portion of it. And I just wanted the first one for my collection because it's pretty. Now I have it. That is my March. Oh, should I talk about games? Yeah. Lastly, I'm going to talk about these two games that I got, which obviously aren't books, but they're book related, so I felt like it was relevant, and I want to share them with you guys. The first one is the Hobbit edition of Love Letter. I've actually never played this game. I almost played it one time, like we even dealt out the cards and everything, but we just didn't get to it because more people showed up and we wanted to play a game that would include more people instead of being antisocial and only playing with a few people. It looks really fun, and also the best part is that the game pieces are like the Arkenstone. They're like little diamonds. It's gonna be so fun. And there's smog cards and lots of stuff. So I'm really looking forward to playing this. And the UK edition of Harry Potter Trivial Pursuit, which is only sold in the UK. So yours truly had to buy it on eBay, like the UK eBay site, because I need it. There's no planned time of when it'll be available in the United States. So it was worth the extra shipping because I have to have this. And so many of my friends have already been like, I need to play that with you. And I'm like, yes, I will play this with anybody, anytime, forever. Because it's the complete Harry Potter Trivial Pursuit, and it's just gonna be so much fun. And like, I just have this vision of tons of people getting together to play and us all like competing by house. I feel like there will probably be a lack of Hufflepuffs because I don't really have any Hufflepuff friends, but if you know any, let me know and maybe they'll get invited to our next game night. That is my March book haul, and I will see you guys soon with another video. Bye!
Red light. 1, 2, 3.
Green light. So, March book haul. Whoa, why are you talking to Siri while I'm filming a video? It's the first book in the Mortal... What is it? No. Why am I thinking Mortal Instruments? Okay, not even close. I believe it's called the His Fair Assassins trilogy. But... Oh, actually, yes, it is. It says it right here on the spine. By the same people that did Pretty Little... Which is why I picked up the first one, because I don't know. I always just, well, whatever. Just cut this. I don't need to talk anymore. I have this.